The arenas that were the hardest to play.
Minnesota Wild versus St. Louis Blues.
Because, you know, mainly our proximity to the ice back in those days in the old arenas and just how physical and intense the games were.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, for me, it's Montreal Forum, and I mean that as a visitor and as a member of the Montreal Canadiens. You had to win. It was not easy to play there, even as a member of the Canadiens. And then I put Boston Garden right there.
Yeah. The old odd to Buffalo was no fun. The Chicago Stadium, of course. And now behind the play, we've got Niederreiter and Petrangelo face-to-face.
Yeah, a little collision along the walls which started that when St. Louis dumped the puck inside the zone. Niederreiter's played well for Minnesota. He's a big kid. He's gotten a good chance to play in Minnesota. He was obtained in that Cal Clutterbuck trade. And he's one of their biggest hitters. He plays the body. He gets in on it. And he got a piece of the number one defenseman for the St. Louis Blues and took him into the wall. Petrangelo didn't particularly like it. That was a pretty nasty cross-check that Petrangelo came back up with, protecting himself, where sometimes it's worth the 2 minutes to show somebody that, hey, I'm not going to open myself up to hits like that. Now, St. Louis has to kill this penalty off, but Petrangelo came back with a pretty nasty little cross-check.
Yeah, he gets the only call here. So, once again, the Wild, after being shorthanded three consecutive times in this game, have had three straight power plays. There's Koivu, diagonal pass, Pominville, goes back to Koivu, saved by Halak, and it's covered up.
Oh, that's great puck movement. Really well done there by Pominville. Pominville, I think, was a little sorry that he didn't pull the trigger, but, you know, he ended up making a terrific pass to Koivu anyway. It was Suter, Koivu, and Pominville involved at the umbrella at the top. There's Koivu back to Pominville. Pominville moved in, see, double clutch. I think he wanted to take the shot, but, boy, he sold everybody. And then he got it to Koivu, waited for that to open. The lane was there. Koivu was smart enough to get in the right place. Instant shot on net, just couldn't find the back of it.
Now Suter with it, walks the line, sends it across. Pominville back to Suter, back to Pominville. Right-hand shot on that side of the ice. Now Koivu. Suter for Pominville again. He'll let it go, deflected wide. Heatley picks it up. Omeister rides into the corner. Under 5 minutes to go in regulation time. It's still a 2-0 St. Louis lead. But the Wild trying to get within one here on the power play. Pominville, long-range shot. Good stick by Backes. Laid up the boards by Pollock, but Charlie Coyle has it now. Coyle, the former BU standout, hands it off to Koivu. Now it comes straight away for Suter. Suter waits. Now he lets it go. Blocked by Steen. Steen protecting the puck because he couldn't play with a stick.
He broke his stick.
Now Suter hands it off for Coyle. Steen went to the bench, got the stick. The puck came to him. Well, then he didn't quite do with it what he wanted to do.
Charlie Coyle didn't play that right because Steen had his stick broken on the original shot. And he was rushing back into the play, so there was room on Coyle's side. He threw it back over to the side that was closest to the St. Louis bench. You have to be aware when a guy doesn't have a stick, that's where you have to work the puck. If the guy stays out there, you can go right up to him because what's he going to do without a stick? In this case, Steen was scrambling back from the bench.
Faceoff control by the Wild. Brodziak passed across for Spurgeon, didn't get through. 45 seconds remaining in the St. Louis minor penalty. Against Alex Petrangelo for cross-checking his goal. Handled by a couple of Minnesota players. Now chased down to the far side. The two number 21s come together. Brodziak and Berglund. They come together again. Brodziak, nice feed out to the line. Spurgeon doesn't have the shooting lane. Brodin back to Spurgeon. On the far side. Brodziak again backs up toward the blue line. Under 20 seconds remaining in the St. Louis penalty. Now Brodin, Spurgeon a one-timer, missed it by much.
It's a better setup like that, though, with Brodin in the middle and Spurgeon on the other side for the one-timer.
Niederreiter's shot doesn't get through. Now Brodziak again, but Petrangelo is up on the box. He's down on the ice. Jackman has it. Has the chip of the line. It was blocked, picked up by Cook, but his shot didn't get through. Spurgeon in deep again. The Blues get to it. It's backhanded by Jackman. All the way back down on Minnesota blue line. Under 3:10, 3:05 now remaining here in the third. Off the stick of Fontaine, and he angled that up onto the netting. and out of play. Well, you can watch live out-of-market games with NHL Game Center Live. One subscription lets you watch on your computer, smartphone, tablet, and connected devices. Visit NHL.com/GCL.
Well, the game slowed down a lot, and St. Louis lost some of their offensive punch that they had through most of the first half of the game, where they pretty much dominated and scored those early goals. But that's to be expected. Minnesota done a better job of clogging things down as well, too. And then they got a couple of power plays and had some more puck possession.
Gandela pressured in deep. Tarasenko gets to it for the Blues. That hit, his stick lifted by Coyle. You know, Mike Yeo told us this morning, Brian, he said, you know, I saw some things in the Chicago series last year, not often enough, not sustained enough. He said, we can compete with the best in this league. And he felt that even before training camp, this team was going to be able to compete. He knows that this was a big test here. So far, they haven't had an answer for the bigger, heavier St. Louis Blues as the Tarasenko shot goes in just high and wide.
You're right, Dave, but they're still hanging around. You know, they haven't let the game get out of control. St. Louis has run some teams out when they get you on the ropes.
Yep.
They had Minnesota early on, so that's a testament to them there. But this is a tough group in blue to handle.
Niederreiter sends it far side. Poivu. Berglund on him, and he put it right through the area in front of the St. Louis net. Under 2 minutes now remaining here. In regulation time, and the empty net down to our right. Extra attacker is on for the Wild. They're down by two. Here's Brody, top of the circle shot. And Halak has it through traffic. And a couple of jabs with the sticks.
St. Louis will play like this, too, and you should. Pretty well every team does. You got to protect.